not a program. We'll just let God have his way. So we're going to have Sister Denise Collins with the special selection now. And then afterward, right after Toledo, we'll come and give us a poem.
I guess I didn't dodge that one. Sister Dorothy was determined for me to sing. Praise God. I love you, sis. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I will lift up mine eyes into the hills, says Psalms 121. Hallelujah, from whence cometh my help. My help does come from the Lord. He does make heaven and earth. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Pray with me, please. I will lift up mine eyes to the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, the Lord who made heaven and earth. He said he will not suffer thy foot to be moved. It's the Lord that keepeth thee. He will not slumber nor sleep.
A year ago, she couldn't even talk. Praise God. And that comes from her. Thank you, Sister Denise, for letting us see how great our God is.
Say that this actually was easy for me because when you called me, it was like, can you do a reading?
you know, or a point or whatever. And I said, I could do that. Well, Thanksgiving just passed, and I was spending time, you know, with my family like everybody else was doing. And after everybody had left, me and my older sister, we was kind of just hanging around, you know, helping my mom clean up the mess from after everybody had left. And we got in this conversation, and somehow the conversation took a turn. And we start talking about, you know, just love and relationships and stuff like that. And my brother and my sister-in-law, they were married during this church. And my sister, she said something to my mom. And my mom was like, you know, I was talking to your brother the other day, and he told me that he remembered when he came to the church, and him and Keisha, my sister-in-law was back there, she was like, he told me that he remembered when he came for the marriage and relationship class and everything, and he was like, you know, he really felt blessed to be, you know, in that class and be here at the church, and he really spoke highly of Pastor Hill and Sister Hill, you know, as far as them being counselors and stuff like that. So to hear that coming from my family, that really blessed me to hear that. So, you know, Pastor Hill, Sister Hill, they are, I don't know how to put it, well, you know, I look up to you and Pastor Hill. And to be celebrating y'all's 50th anniversary, that's really a milestone. And that's something that that's a milestone that I hope to celebrate. But, you know, I know that one day I will, but I just wanted to let you know that, you know, good news do travel fast, and, you know, it blessed me to know that, you know, that's how they felt. So, when I read this, it's actually a read. I like to read poems and quotes and stuff like that, and I just kind of keep it all in my journal and mix it up. Some of it's mine, some of it's somebody else's, but, you know, when I read it, I said, you know, I got to read this. So, it says, the best expression of love is spending time. The importance of things can be measured by how much time we are willing to invest in them. The more time you give something, the more you reveal the importance and the value to you. If you want to know a person's priorities, just look at how they use their time. You can make more money, but you can't make more time. The greatest gift you give someone is your time. 1 Corinthians 14:1 says, let love be your greatest aim. Love should be your top priority, primary objective, and greatest ambition. It means giving up, yielding your preferences, comforts, goals, security, money, time, energy for someone, for someone else's benefit, I'm sorry. Life without love is really worthless. Relationships, not achievements, or the acquisition of things, are what matters most in life. The point of life is learning to love God and people, because a life without love is nothing. 1 Corinthians 13:3 says, no matter what I say, what I believe, and what I do, I am bankrupt without love. Love will last forever, is eternal. Love leaves a legacy. Love is the secret of a lasting heritage. It is not enough just to say relationships are important. You must prove it by investing time in them. Words alone are worthless. 1 John 3:18 says, my children, our love should not be just words and talk. It must be true. It must be true love, which shows itself in action. And focused attention says, I value you enough to give you my most precious asset, my time. Whenever you give your time, you are making a sacrifice, and a sacrifice, no, and sacrifice is the essence of love. The essence of love is not what we think, we do, or we provide for others, but how much we give of ourselves.
And, you know, Sunday after Sunday, we see, you know, Pastor Hill and Sister Hill together. And I so love Pastor Hill, especially when he cracks his little jokes about, you know, my time is up, gotta go. You know, and Sister Hill, she's playing her little card, you know. I love it. I love it. I love his sense of humor, his personality, and hers too. I mean, they just complement each other so well to me, you know. So, you and Pastor Hill, y'all have really blessed me throughout the years, me being here in Northside, and, you know, I wish you and Pastor Hill another 50. 100. Y'all be 100.
Thank you for that, Sister Khalila. Praise God. I tell you, now, just in case you didn't have your spiritual ears on, you can't figure out how that worked into our theme today. Praise God. You know when God says that I'm with you always, even to the end of the earth? Jesus, when he said that, if I'm not mistaken, it was when he was commissioning his disciples, right after he had, before he was ready to ascend to the throne, to tell us to go take the gospel throughout the world. And that seemed like a really, really hard, that seemed like an impossible task. You know, if you look at it with natural eyes, praise God. And that's why he had to remind them that, hey, you're not doing this alone, I'm with you. Our help comes from the Lord. And the ultimate expression of love, as Sister Khalila says, is what we give of ourselves. And when we're willing to take that time and to obey God and fulfill that commission, because it wasn't just for the disciples, it was for us to take his love to the whole world. Praise God. Thank you for that, Sister Khalila. Next, we're going to have Sister Alicia Wayne. You know, I'm just, when I think of children's church, and I think of all my children's church kids, and to see them all grown up and ministering to the Lord, and I am so proud of them. And Sister Alicia was one of my very, well, all my kids were special. But Sister Alicia, she was so sweet, she's still so sweet. Praise God.
I'm here to give my testimony. Really nervous, so pray for me. But I really just want to talk about how my help comes from God. And I have a lot of testimonies that I haven't got a chance to share, and you know, but I'm going to keep it short today. I've been with my company about a little bit over 2 years now, and making minimum wage, and didn't seem like it was helping into me having a hard time paying rent. And I kind of got to the point where I was like, I love where I'm at, but it's time for me to move on, try to find another job. And I was putting in applications everywhere I stopped at the grocery store, I put in an application, stopped at the bank, I put in an application, everywhere I went, I was putting in applications. But, you know, doing hair isn't really qualifying me to work at a bank, or, you know, they want you to have 3 years of experience here, or this degree or that degree, and all I have is my cosmetology license. And then that instructor's license doesn't mean anything to them, really. So it was difficult finding another job. And just when I got to the point where I felt like I wanted to give up, just quit, and then go off of unemployment until I could find something else, or God blessed me. I got promoted to assistant manager, and you know, it was just a couple of quarters better, but hey, that was like $1,000 to me. I was very excited. You know, I got my foot in the door, got to meet supervisors, people I never thought I would meet within our company, and got to learn a lot. Then I heard that they were applying for a manager at our stores. We had 3 new stores open. And so I was like, well, this is what I want to do. This is where I feel like I need to be. And so I was like, well, put in that application. If this is what God wants me to do, then he's going to help me along the way. And so I put in my application, and several weeks go by. I interviewed. I had 3 interviews, and I hadn't heard a word. And 2 of the stores already opened, and they found their managers for that. There was 1 store left, and I was like, it was between me and another one of my coworkers. And I was like, well, amen. So I just continued to pray, and well, my best friend, one of my coworkers, she got the position, so I was just like, well, maybe it wasn't for me, but you know, God always has a plan. There's always another story. So I just continued to be me, work hard, and do what I know to do until God tells me what's next. And so a little bit after that, our manager at our store, she quit. And so our supervisor came to me. She was like, this is exactly what I wanted. I hate that it has happened this way, but you belong at this store. And the girls respect you, you respect them, you all work well together, and you've been managing the store before you even became manager, and so now I want to pay you for what you've been doing. And so I got the position. God has opened so many doors that are coming for me, and I've been manager maybe 3 hours, and they're like, oh, you have your first meeting with the corporate office, or people from Minnesota was coming down, they're excited to meet me, and I was just like, wow, really? Okay. So of course I was nervous, and our store was the first store to get the new computer, and I was just like, now what I'm going to do with this new computer? I don't even know what I'm doing right now. So they came to train us. Well, long story short, not only did I was the first person to understand the computer, but I'm teaching my managers, my supervisors, their managers, as well as the rest of the employees within the company. So, you know, anytime they have trouble, they call, hey, at least you can come to the store. I can clock in without having to stand up on my feet all day, cutting hair. I can just be like, hey, I'm going to clock in and help you with the computer. And, you know, I'm so grateful for God and everything that he's done, and all everybody who's been praying for me and helping me out and just coming up to the shop and seeing me. That means the world to me, so thank you.
And it's no surprise, praise God, that God has done this for Alicia, because God does take care of his people. All things work together for the good of those who love the Lord and are the called. And we are the called according to his purpose, praise God. You know, I was talking to a family member sometime about, and they were talking about different things. And they were talking about, you know, and even as a children's church leader, I've seen hundreds of kids come through here that really loved and served and knew how to serve the Lord. And some of them you see are still serving the Lord, and some of them you don't. But those that I know that we know what we put in them, the word that's in them, I'm just so proud when I look at our Alicia's and Jessica's and Brother Sammy, praise God, that word got in them, and you see what God is doing through his word. You know, you see people like Pastor Hill and Brother Donald up here, you think, okay, well, they're old, they know where their help comes from. But it's so wonderful to see young people who know where their help comes from. Praise God. Now it's time for one of the most exciting parts of our service. It's time to give. Praise God. We're going to have Sister Deborah come to make the offering appeal.
Sister Candy said it just like I was thinking when Sister Dorothy called me. Well, yeah, I can do that. I like that part. I love praise and worship, and I consider offering, giving time, part of my praise and worship. That's my opportunity to show God, yes, I love you, and yes, I will obey you. And so I probably can't make this appeal like you used to, Elder Williams, Pastor Donnell. All the titles. But the scripture came to me, and it's our standard scripture that you've probably heard over and over, Malachi 3:10. But as you, as Malachi was a prophet and a messenger of the Lord in the Old Testament, is for example, after he talked about robbing God, he told us what happens when we obey God and do what he says to do about, and Sister Kalila mentioned relationship and what's priority for us, and giving of ourselves. And a lot of times we think, you know, that God blesses us and gives to us, and it is just not. And it is not. We have a responsibility with that part of what God gives us as well. And in Malachi 3:10, it says, bring all the tithes, offering, tithes, you know, is that dime off of a dollar. If you pull it together, and we'll teach you, I'm a children's church person too. So you show, you got 10 dimes, and one of them is the Lord's, and you get all of this. If you just do what God said to do, just simple. So bring all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house, and prove me now herewith, said the Lord of hosts, if I will not open the windows of heaven, open the doors of opportunity, Sister Alicia. You don't have to go nowhere. You don't have to do nothing special. He will make a way for you. He'll make room for you. I'll open the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that there will not be room enough to receive it. Sometimes I look around and go, ooh, wee, I got so many little stuff, pens, and you look, you start putting stuff in a box, Sister Dorothy, giving it to somebody else because God has given you things that, you know, even more than enough. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. Your car won't break. Your tires will keep rolling on slick. God will rebuke the devourer for your sake, and he shall not destroy the fruits of your ground, neither shall he, neither shall your vine cast their fruit before their time in the field, said the Lord of hosts. And all the nations shall call you blessed, and you shall be a delightsome land. People will just know that she's so pleasant. You can be going through things and nobody even knows it, because you know where your help comes from. So apropos the topic today. And in a time like this, God, you know, I listened to the news and those with American, and you know, I thought even then, if you know where your help comes from, it's just okay, because God's gonna make that way. He's gonna open that next opportunity. But this is the time you get to show him, yes, Lord, I will obey, and I will bring the tithes and offering to the storehouse. And at this time, I encourage you to do that. And we have another opportunity. Typically on Women's Sunday, we have Fifth Sunday, typically, and we're so kind of unorthodox here at Northside. I just love it. You know, we don't maybe do the Fifth Sunday in the white, but we know it's this Sunday, and we honor our First Lady. Typically on Women's Day, it is that opportunity. We love her, we see her. She's that person that just sits in the corner. She's that delightsome person. And we thank God for their 50 years anniversary, but it's an opportunity. And I encourage you, we don't do a lot of those orthodox kinds of things as well, but we know that our pastor's wife does many, 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 many things in the background. She listens to many, 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 many stories, and she goes through a lot of things that we are never aware of. So if you, we encourage you to bless the First Lady of the House today. Bless Sister Hill today. Again, it's First Women's Day. Pastor has allotted us this time, and we encourage you, as you give your tithes, now don't short the Lord, you give your tithes and your offerings to the house, to also bless Sister Hill this Sunday. If you all stand, we'll turn you in the hands of the ushers. And while you stand, Lord, we ask you to bless this offering. Bless those that give. Bless those that have not to give, that they have to give the next time, God. We honor you today with the first fruits of our labor, God, and our that and above our offerings, God. We ask you to bless our pastor in his absence, God, that the purpose that he is out to do, that it's prosperous as well. All these things we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.